We are flooded with news of the pandemic, the impact it's having on economies, on industries, and on people. But have we ever thought of turning the lens the other way, finding out the impact of the pandemic on the reporters who are bringing you these stories? For the very first time, Canada and the UK presented a Media Freedom Award to drive international action on improving the safety of journalists around the world. There were five nominees from Belarus, Mexico, Lebanon, South Sudan, and Sri Lanka. And I asked Sri Lanka's shortlisted nominee, Ranga Kalansuriya, who is Asia's regional advisor for international media support, if our journalists are suitably equipped to cover the pandemic.
I don't think even to cover this pandemic, they are well trained. They know the subject. I don't think so, because it's all of a sudden it emerged and journalists are not ready to cover that. So they do mistakes. Even after 11 months, we have not learned from those mistakes. We are still doing the mistakes. We repeat the mistakes. Even the media stations, or even the government, is not taking action to capacitate the journalists to cover the COVID-19 pandemic. Justifiable salary for journalists, recognition, and most importantly, freedom to work in the newsroom. I'm not talking about the government here. I'm talking about the corporate influence, the politically motivated or economically motivated ownership that pressure the newsroom. So what we see today in the news bulletin is not the freedom of expression. This is what your owner wants us to hear or listen or watch. That's not safe enough for journalists.
Technology is key in moving forward to transform every challenging moment into a profit, where manual becomes digital, business becomes smart, and lives become smarter. People's Bank Online Corporate Banking. It's truly the change you need.